So based on the concept of stack, so last Saturday we started the concept of stack. So I just explained the structure of a stack. Okay, so my concept, as I said, so this module is being divided into linked list and stack, but most of the portions are into the linked list, and we could expect in the module 3 subpart the concept of stack. Okay, so theoretically there are not much of the concepts included in these concepts. So two concepts are there. One is I'll just show you here. Okay, so one concept is very simple, that is on a array representation of the stack, that is array implementation of a stack and a linked list implementation of a stack. So only two concepts are being included into your syllabus. So we have a program. So today we would see a program based on the concept of array implementation of the stack. Array implementation of the stack. So operations, what is stack, push, pop, these things we have seen Monday, that is on Saturday's class, with the animation I shown you how exactly the stack works, right? What is the basic concept of a stack, right? So you could see over here. So what is a stack, and how does the structure of a stack looks like, right? And I said, where do you represent the stack pointer? The stack pointer is called as a top. The top value will be -1. So I stress you that it will be shown at the base of the stack here when it is empty. If the top, so this is called top, whose value is top equals to -1. So if top equals to -1, we say that stack is empty, right? The value of top will be 0 when A is inserted. Again, the top is indicating at the value called 0. Okay, at the value called 0. Again, the stack, the top is here when you insert A. Again, when you insert B, right, the top value become 1. The top will be incremented. So this is the way. Again, when C is incremented, the top value is 2. So this is the way. How do we? So again, the top value will be 3. Similarly, the top value will be 4, right? So the maximum size of a stack here is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Imagine it is 5 as such. When you think like that, the maximum capacity of the stack is equals to 5. If stack size, that is if the top, sorry, if the value of top equals to stack size -1, what is stack size? Stack size -1 is, stack size is 5, stack size -1. So we say that stack is full. That is if the value of top, if the value of top equals to stack size -1, so we say that it is full, hence we can pop the stack. So this was what being explained on 7:30 class and Saturday. So today we will see array representation, that is writing a program using the concept of arrays to push and pop and to display the elements of the stack. Okay, so we have stack pointer. So this is what being explained. Now let me go to the concept of stack, that is insertion, deletion, and few of the algorithms. So if the top equals to maximum size, then so what you have to return true, right? That is top index of the stack is initialized to -1 always. So that is a basic thing. Always at the beginning, the we do initialize the value of top equals to -1. When you are going to insert, that is push, when you are going to apply the push operation, if the stack is full, then we are not going to push anything. That is simply you return null. Else you are going to increment the top by 1, and you are going to go on inserting the data to the stack of top. That is stack of top, to the memory of the stack of top where the top is indicating. What is the meaning of top? Top is nothing but a stack pointer. Stack pointer is nothing but it is an arrow that is indicating the memory element of a stack. This is a stack pointer. See, this is a stack pointer. So this is indicating the memory location of the stack top. So we are going to insert the element and we are going to increment the top. We are going to insert and we are going to increment the top as such. So this was being explained last class. Simply I'm explaining as we have to go with the program today based on the concepts of algorithm. Okay. Similarly, we have pop. Pop is very simple. So we are just deleting the stack of top and we are decrementing the top. See, in the case of incrementing, increment the top, insert the element to the stack of top. Here in this case, first, when you identify the data stack of top, decrement the top by minus one. This is a pop operation. But before you do the push operation, whether you check whether the stack is full or not, how do you identify stack is full? Right? That is by matching the size of the top equals to stack size minus one. If the size of the top equals to stack size minus one, we are not going to push it. We say that stack is full. Else we are going to push it by using these concepts. Let me go to the program. So try to understand pop, very simple concept. So pop means you have to delete it. You have to delete the element from the stack. Stack follows last in, first out. Last in, first out. Last element, we are going to remove it from the. So all of you, I request you to be attentive in the class. Try to understand this concept is quite easy compared to the linked list concepts. Once again, I have prepared few of the programs that you need to go through for the examination point of view. So maybe I'll give it by today evening into the Google Classroom. So my request as of now is please hear the session properly. I'll not take your more time. Just concentrate. What is a push operation? What is a pop operation? And how do you display the elements of the stack? So because I'll go right now to the program. Okay. So algorithm push, algorithm pop. Here is a code actually. So by using a pointer variable. So using pointer variable in linked list we come across. Right. We'll see that. So let me go to the program now. Let me go to the program now. Hope the screen is visible to all of you. So stack representation, last class I explained what is stack theoretically, right? I explained the stack representation in memory. How do you identify the size of the stack? Difference between a stack, arrays and stacks, that is a very important concept I explained. So array, basically you can fetch the data from any end, maybe in between, but in the case of stack, it is not. Though it is a linear non-primitive data structure, we cannot directly access the middle element or from wherever, front or rear. So it follows the last in first order. The last element which has been inserted is going to be popped up at the first. In the same way, by using one of the index called a stack pointer. Remember, you have to write this theoretical point, not as it is. You have to write on your own words. Arrays provides adding flexibility or removing the data anywhere in the list, whereas stack will not provide it. Theoretically, this could be an examination question, differentiate between arrays and stack. Maybe for 4 marks, they might ask. And one of the major concept that is the application of arrays is into the inventory management, employee records management as such. Whereas the application of stack is into the problems such as recursion control or the expression evaluation. The expression evaluation consists of postfix expression, prefix expression, so as such. So though we don't have a programs on postfix and prefix expression, so we are going to see only the concept of array representation and the stack representation of the linked list. So let us go to the program, because today and tomorrow we are going to finish the concepts of stack. So we'll go with some of the other concepts as the request from the students is to explain few programs on the linked list. Definitely I'm preparing few of the programs where you can focus or concentrate or understand. Along with that, we are going to complete this. So my planning is to focus more on this concept of stack rather than linked list in order to cover the questions that could be arise from the module 3. So this has been explained by me. How does the initial stack looks like? So top is null. Always top is null means it is empty. So its value is minus one, and this stack pointer is indicated over here at the base, okay, not here. So when you insert it, so he has in 3, 5, so two elements are inserted. When you insert 3, stack pointer will indicate here. When you insert 3, when you insert 5, the stack pointer will indicate here. Okay, so this is the way. Then next, immediately what you are going to do, right, when you pop it, last in first out, last in first out means 5 is popped up. When 5 is popped up, this top will decrement here. It will decrement here, the same concept what I explained theoretically. Now let me see. Similarly, again in between you can push 7, push 99, push, so you are going to push, so this is a 7, okay, this is a 7 just modified. So again, now coming to the concept of program, push operation, the same algorithm what I stated. For a push operation, first you check whether stack is empty or not. That is, if the value of top equals to max minus 1, why it is max minus 1? Stack size is being defined. Okay, top starts from 0, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4. If the value of 4 equals to stack size minus 1, imagine stack size is 5, 5 minus 1, 4 equals to 4, stack is full. So hence we cannot insert. So display stack is full. So simply you exit, simply exit of the program. Or else what you can do, you can insert the element by increasing the stack pointer. Top is called stack pointer, top equals to top plus 1, and store the element into the stack of top. First it will be into minus 1, no? See, imagine it will be into minus 1. Increment the stack pointer becomes 0. That is the pointer where it is indicating. Then you insert the element 2. So this is the way. Again, it is being repeated till here. When it reaches the stack of size minus 1 equals to top, you can stack is full. So this algorithm, 100% I do expect this questions for examination. Write an algorithm to implement push operation and write a code for push operation. So once again, I feel the people who have been discouraged with the concepts of data structures, so I purely insist you to go through this concept of stack operations, because you have very simple concept, push pop operation with respect to the array, push pop operation with respect to the linked list, and algorithms are also very simple compared to the data structure algorithms. You can see we have start, we have stop. First step number 2, check whether the stack is full. How do you check? That is tallying whether the value of top equals to max minus 1. So if you have heard this my Saturday session, you would have understand this scenario of the situation, right? Then incrementing the stack pointer, you are going on inserting the elements to the top. Similarly, pop element. Pop is being used to eliminate. So since the stack follows last in first out operation, so what you have to go is you are going to tally whether the stack, whether the value of top equals to minus 1, that is nothing is there in the stack. If nothing is there in the stack, you go to the step 4 saying that nothing is there, stack is empty. Display the message stack is empty. Sorry, if top equals to minus 1, go to step 3. Else what you do? So you are going on decrementing the stack pointer, that is top equals to top minus 1, and return stack of top. You are going to return it, that is you are going to delete stack of top. You are going to delete it. You're going to read. See, pop is nothing but you are going to read and decrement the stack pointer. Okay, so hopefully able to follow this algorithm. So now let me go to the concept of implementation. Implementation is a writing a program. So before you write a program, so I'll represent today one operation on implementation of the stack using arrays. So concentrate, all of you have to strictly concentrate on this concept to write a program. So we have in this program, he has demonstrated stack using arrays. He has implemented inserting the elements into the stack, deleting the elements from the stack, displaying the elements from the stack. So let me go to the direct output of this program so that you understand the things. So the program has been written using switch operation, okay, switch case. That is using choice 1. In the case of choice one, what he has mentioned is you are going to push the elements. You are going to push the elements. That is choice one. Select the choice from the following. That is by using switch. On pressing the keyboard one, it will show to the push operation. Similarly, enter the elements to be pushed. So we are going to push the elements. Choice one, third element, three elements are inserted. Then, if you want to display the stack elements, you choose three. So stack elements are, see, you inserted the first element, which is the first element that you inserted. Enter the element to be pushed into the stack. You pushed one. So can you just have a scenario on this diagrammatical representation? If this is a stack, one is pushed. So next, again, push the elements to be stacked. Two is pushed, right? Again, three is pushed. Try to understand, all of you. So earlier, top equals to minus one. So it moved to zero, it moved to one, it moved to two. The value of top equals to two. This is the way how you have inserted. Suddenly, you ask the choice three to display the elements. So how do you display the elements, all of you? How do you display the elements? Now you could see, how do we display the elements? Enter the choice. See, various elements of stack are, it is being displayed as if like the structure of the stack. One, two, three. See, last in, first out. Last elements is visible first here. This stack pointer, okay? Value of top, value of top, value of top. Value of top at this position is zero. Value of top equals to minus and at the base when it is empty. Now you entered the, enter your choice three. You are going to display it. When you are going to display it, you are going to see what? The elements 3, 2, 1, because last in, first out. So last element is the first element to be popped up. Okay. So hopefully this you have understood now. Select the choice from the following again, right? Choice is two, that is to delete the elements. How do you delete? So how do you delete the elements? Your choice is two. When you enter two, automatically three is being deleted because the function is being written as per the stack concept. Last in, first out, three is deleted and this pointer will come to the one, right? Again, enter your choice. Again, three. When you press three, three means to display. What is to be displayed? 2, 1 has to be displayed. See, 2, 1 is to be displayed. This is how the operations of stack works. Again, select the choice from the following, right? Fourth is a exit. So when you pop, 2, 1 has to be shown. Similarly, if you press again, pop, 2 has to be increment, 2 has to be deleted by decrementing the stack pointer. So this is all about the structure of the output that is being given to explain the stack pointers using arrays. Now, let us see this program. First concept on this switch operation using arrays. So this is while of one means signifying the infinite loop. That is, it will going to execute until the statement with the jump statement. What are jump statement? For example, here break. It is unconditional break. Break, break are all the jump statements. Once immediate, it comes out of the complete loop. Okay, so this is the common. This is a common statements. That is, you have written this within the while statement. Remember, okay, while starts over here. Select a choice from the following. So we have taken on pressing one, push an element. On pressing two, pop an element. That is a case. Case one means push. Case two means you have to delete, pop. Case three means display. Case four means exit. Okay. So you have taken the number as percentage D. Percentage means, D means enter your choice. Okay. Enter your choice of a program. So within the while loop, we have switch case. Remember, within the while loop, we have a switch case. Switch off choice. Choice is a number that you enter from the keyboard. Remember, choice, percentage D, and choice, no? It is a number that you enter into the keyboard. Switch off choice. when it is a case one, you have to enter the element that is to be pushed into the stack. Enter the elements to be pushed into the stack. Scanf, what you are going to push? You are going to push number one, okay? And num1, memory of num1, and you call the function called push of. This is a main function that we have to understand. That is, this program is a simple program using switch statement to push, pop, display, and the exit by using switch statement. So it is being written within while loop. Why within while loop? Because you may do many push operations. You may do many pop operations, irrespective of the condition, right? You may use option three to display many times the number of the status of the stack in between, right? So based on that, so case one, you are going to enter the element to be pushed into the stack. Push num1. So let us go to the push num1. What happens? The control goes to the push operation. What is push operation? It is being written over here. See void push. It is a non-returnable function, right? Int element. Int element is nothing but num1. When you put and num1, num1 will be copied over here. Num1 will be copied over here. Is it or not? From case one, push num1 means e num1, the number will be copied to the element called int element. Once you copy the int element, now this element has to be pushed into the stack. First, now let us verify whether the stack is empty or not. You verify whether the stack equals to the maximum size reached. How do you identify that? That is being identified. That is, you compare whether top equals to, that is stack of size minus one. That is, so he has used the memory stack of size in the initialization, top equals to 99. Stack is full or not? Stack of size is 100. That is not, it has to be defined at the initialization, stack of size, right? If the value of top equals to stack size minus one, stack size is 100. So stack size minus one is 99. If top equals to 99, we say that stack is full and you simply exit. Stack is full, you simply exit. Whereas else, see if is over here, else, see, and here, what is this loop? This is the end of while, remember. So this is the end of main, this is end of while, while end, this is main end, and this is your switch end. Try to understand. I'm telling you the end of the brackets. So this is the end of main. Function call goes over here. Try to understand. When you call function, first verify whether the stack is full. How do you verify? Whether value of top equals to stack size minus one. Stack size minus one. So if the stack size is 100, that is being initialized, stack size equals to 100. So 99 is the 100 minus one is 99. Else, what you do? First, you increment the stack pointer to top minus one, top equals to top plus one, then store the element into the, store the element into the stack of top. So to the memory of stack of top, you enter the element, you enter one. Again, enter your choice is being asked. So you enter push, that is enter your choice from the switch statement, enter one. Again, you enter, again, it will verify whether it is full or else you are going to push two. Okay. Again, similarly, three is going to push, top is going to increment, stack pointer is going to increment till it reaches 99. So this is the very simple program to push the elements using the concepts of array stack, that is stack using arrays. Stack of top equals to element, stack of top. What is stack of top? Stack of top is this. Stack of top is this, right? Whereas top is the indicator. This arrow is the top. That is minus one at the base, zero at this point, one, two as such. Now, if I have understood, so let me go to the pop operation. So switch operations, switch choice, you enter case 1, case 2, case 2, immediately what is that? Pop. See how this operation is pop is being called, all of you. There is a different concept. Push followed by the number. Pop, you apply pop to the num2. Try to understand, all of you. So once again, see, push operation is being called with respect to the number what has to be pushed. Pop, simply you call pop, and pop will apply to the num2. What is num2? Num2 is nothing but the number which has to be deleted from the stack. So when you call pop, first control, it will go downside. That return value will be stored into num2. When you call pop, imagine as per your program that is being given, 1 is inserted, 2 is inserted, 3 is inserted. Okay, so 3 elements are inserted. Now the top is indicating at the here. Okay, that is 0, 1, 2. It has notched reached 99. Now let me go to the downside and show you what does the operations pop does. Okay, see, here is the pop operation. Int pop. So what happens is, first, whether stack is empty, top equals to -1, no, it is not empty, then stack is empty, or else you simply come out. So, or else what you have to do, you return, that is, you store the stack pointer as top -1, that is, returning the top element. How do you returning the top element? It will return, means it will delete, returning the top element and decrementing the pointer. This 3, no? 3 will be returned to upside. Pop, when you call pop, 3 will be returned. See, return stack of top -. So this statement, what it does, it return this value 3 to pop above, pop to num2. So num2 will be with 3 by decrementing the stack pointer top -. So now you go upside. No, go upside. What happens now? The percentage D element popped. That is 3. The percentage D element popped out of the stack is num2. That is 3. Number element 3 is popped out of the stack. So how do you get num2? The num2 pop will return. Pop will return num3 from the stack for the first iteration when you insert 1, 2, 3. As per the program, I have just explained it. Okay. So hopefully able to understand push and pop operation. It is using an array. If you understand this using the linked list, you find it easy. And I'm stressing once more. So these programs are quite easy compared to the other data structures, that is linked list programs. Very simple concept, pop, check whether the stack is empty, or else you have to return the stack. This is for deleting. Return means what? It will simply return the value by decrementing the stack pointer. Okay. So similarly, we have other programs to be studied. So display of the stack. See, display of the stack is very simple by using for loop. So what you are going to do is using for loop, all of you. So you have to display the present situation. For example, if you have 1, 2, 3 inserted to the stack, so the top is indicating at the top position. Okay, the top is indicating the top position. You have to display the contents. How do you display? I equals to top. That is using I. The top is indicating at this position 0, 1, 2. What is 0, 1, 2? The tab value is 2, right? We initialize I equals to top, I equals to 2, I equals to 2, is 2 greater than equal to 0? Yes, it is greater than 0. Then what have to do? Display the stack of I. What is stack of I? Stack of I is 3. Similarly, decrement, it is decrement loop. So 2 is decremented by 3. I equals to top, that I equal to 1. E is 1 greater than equal to 0. Yes, display stack of 1. Stack of 1 is 2. So this is displayed. This is a way, how do we fetch? By using for loop. By using for loop to display the content. Display contents are a general C statements by using a for loop. So basically you have to understand what is push operation and what is pop operations, right? So I had a one more thing here. So as per the one more book, so where the concepts are quite lengthy and C, but I find this book itself is enough for you to understand the concept of stack, because we don't have much elaboration. Yes, again, very simple words. So if you have still want much elaboration with respect to the program, you could refer this program. So that is stack size minus 1. So what you have to do, right? I have forwarded this into the Google Classroom. Again, for a pop operation, see, push when you do the pop operation. So return top equals to minus 1. You check whether it is empty or not. See pop operations. How do you do the pop operation? Or else see return top of minus minus. So here, if the top equals to minus 1, you return minus 1. Or else you return what you have done, stack of top minus minus. So in decrement and return the value of the stack. So this is for a pointer variable. This is by using general array. So I forwarded this document, and I do focus only with respect to the syllabus point of view and book point of view as of now. So I've explained this. So I insist you to go through this program once, because the downside program, what we have by using a stack pointer linked list, this is also one and the same, except few of the changes in the node. See, int element same, we use struct, that's it. So this way I'll explain it tomorrow. So those who have not followed, I insist you to go through once today through this document. I have forwarded into the Google Classroom. If you have not understood, you could raise the questions on this. And the questions I'll give you, what exactly to be studied in this syllabus. In stacks, you don't have any other questions. Exceptionally, explain the difference between arrays and stack. Explain push operation, pop operation, algorithm for push and pop operation, either by using stack or either using arrays, either by using linked list operations. So I request you to give the attendance on the chat session. So those who have not given, and tomorrow I'll be completing this stack operations, and I'll go with the program explanation. See, this is a final analysis. Int stack of 100. This is not was not included in the program. You have to include in the program. Initialize stack of 100. And push operation, pop operation, display operation. When you do push, I said once again, when you do the push operation, so push into number 1, what has to be pushed. Pop means you simply delete the existing element and store that deleted element into num2. Call the pop function for deleting an element from the stack. So how do you call pop? See, when you call pop, pop will delete the element, and deleted element is stored in num2. So push element will push the new element that is being given from the keyboard into the num1. So for popping, we don't give any element. Simply you call pop. The pop element will store automatically num2 to display. Display is simply display function by using for loop, right? So this is top equals to top plus 1. How does we do? Insert the elements to the stack and update the stack pointer. You have to store the element and increment the stack pointer. So I request you to give the attendance. So I request, if I need an answer from you, if is this scanning is it possible for you to view through this scanning, then you could refer it, or else I could do the quality scanning and it'll send you the notes. In fact, so stack 1, this is as per the syllabus. Stack 2 is just for sake of understanding, I have forwarded it. So those who are interested, with respect to all the major concepts of a stack. This is for them. And stack one, this file stack one is for the syllabus. As per the syllabus, I have scanned it from the book what you are referring, stack. This is chapter number 6, part of the module 3. Only array implementation of stack, linked list implementation, and nothing you have. Remember, I'm stressing, so you cannot ask any other questions. You cannot ask any other questions except algorithm for push, pop, and difference between arrays and stack, and write a program for array implementation of stack or simple push operation, pop operation, display operations. So those who have not given the attendance can give the attendance. Those who have given the attendance can leave for the day as of now. Tomorrow we'll join by 12:35, and I'll try to cover all of you once again. I'll try to cover linked list implementation of a stack tomorrow. Along with, I'll repeat those who have not understood for them again the same program, as they are much related. Linked list implementation is same as if like array implementation, except that we use a pointers to store the address of the next node. That is in stack. That's it. Nothing else. It is not a big concept, right? So for that sake, at least we should be knowing what is linked list and what is a node to understand this concept. Okay. So let me stop the session.